Namaste students.
In today's lecture, I'm going to explain about the numericals of the magnification. Fine. In the last lecture, I taught you the formula for the magnification of a lens, that is M is equal to V by U. M is equal to V by U. And also told you about the lens formula, that is 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F. Now the question says, the filament of a bulb is 80 centimeter from a screen. Now first of all, screen, it means, the word screen means where the image is formed. And a converging lens forms an image on screen. It's written that image of screen that is magnified 3 times. Now magnified 3 times means, first of all, magnification is 3 times. It means magnification is 3. We have to find the distance of the lens from the filament and the focal length of the lens. If you understand this situation, question says filament of the bulb is 80 centimeter from screen. Now first let us suppose that this is a lens and this is the principal axis. Suppose somewhere the screen is this side. Fine. This is screen. And this screen is kept 80 centimeter from the filament of the bulb. Let us consider, this is the optical axis. Let us consider this is a place where lamp is kept. Fine. Now, the distance between this point, that is A and B, is what? 80 centimeter. That is distance AB is equal to 80 centimeter. Now, I'll consider let OB is equal to X. If this OB is equal to X, then what is the length of AO? Therefore, AO is equal to 80 minus X. Fine. This is the 80 minus X, because this complete is 80 centimeter. Right? Magnification is given 3. Now we'll use the formula for the magnification. I have written here M is equal to V by U. So M is equal to V by U. What is M? That is 3. What is V? V is the position of image. So what is the position of image? That is how much distance? That is X. So this is X upon U. What is U? That is 80 minus X. Now cross multiply, this will go on the left hand side. This will become 3 multiplied by 80 minus X is equal to X, or it's 240 minus 3X is equal to X. Shift 3x right hand side, this will become 4x is equal to 240, or we can say x is equal to 60. Fine, we got x is equal to 60. Now what was x? That is OB. If I tell you about the distance, that is of distance of an image. So what was this basically? This was basically V. Fine. So it means that V is equal to 60 centimeter. Here it is given units centimeter. Now, in place of V, we have written X. So V is equal to X. So V have got 60. So what is U? U is 80 minus 60 is equal to 20 centimeter. Now, first part is find the distance of the lens from the filament. Fine. So this is the distance of the lamp. This is the distance. That is U is equal to 20. Now second part is, we have to find the focal length of the lens. To find focal length, we use this lens formula. Okay. But please remember, we are using lens formula. But please remember one thing. We have to put in the, we have to put the value in the, by using the Cartesian system. From here, V is how much? 60. So V is equal to 60. It's a centimeter. And what is U? U from Cartesian system, U is on the left hand side. So we can say that U is equal to minus 20 centimeter. Fine, substitute this value in this formula. So we got 1 by f is equal to 1 by v minus 1 by u, and then I'm doing here, that is 1 by f is equal to 1 by v means 1 by 60 minus 1 by minus of 20. This minus minus will become plus. 1 by f is equal to 1 by 60 plus 1 by 20. Take LCM, this will become 60. It will go on 1, it will go on 3. This will become 4 by 60. And when you cancel, this becomes 1 by 15. Fine. That is 1 by f. 1 by f is equal to 1 by 15. So therefore, f is equal to 15 centimeter. Now, in this example, it says an object is placed 4 centimeter in front of converging lens. First of all, what is converging lens? That is convex lens. And image is produced 12 centimeter from lens. If suppose we draw the rough diagram, so this will be the convex lens, and this side is the object, and this side is somewhere the image. Now we have to find the magnification. I have written 3 points. We have to find first magnification, second is focal length, and third we have to draw the ray diagram for given. Now for first, it's given that u is equal to 4 centimeter, v is equal to 12 centimeter. So what is the magnification? Magnification is, that is v by u. So this, it means 12, and this is 4. 4 ones are 4, 3s are. So magnification is 3. Fine. So what's the magnification comes? That is 3. Now come for the second point. That is a focal length. Now apply the formula. 1 by f is equal to 1 by v minus 1 by u. Now to find the focal length, we have to substitute the value of v and u, but when we put the value here, we have to take care of the Cartesian system, Cartesian sign. So 1 by f is equal to 1 by v. 1 by v means 1 by 12 minus 1 by u. What is u? 4. But u is here, so we consider it as a minus. For magnification, the value will be as it is, but for to find the focal length, it will be minus 4. So it means that will become 1 by f is equal to 1 by 12 plus 1 by 4. When you find the LCM, that will be 12. And 12 ones are 12, 1, 4 3s are 12, 3 ones are 3. This will become 4 by 12. And when we do the cutting, that will become 1 by 3. It means 1 by f is equal to 1 by 3, or we can say f is equal to 3 centimeter. Please remember, already taught you that focal length of the converging lens is always positive. Fine. Now next comes the ray diagram. For ray diagram, if I draw a ray diagram for that, this is a convex lens, this is the optical center. Fine. How much is the focal length? 3. So it means, suppose here is f, so this is the point 2f. Focal length is 3, it means OF is 3, and this is also 3. So total is 6. Similarly here, O, and this is f dash, and this is 2f dash. Okay. So what is f? 3. So an object is kept at a 4 centimeter. It means this is 3, this is 3, this is totally 6. So object is kept somewhere here between f and twice of the focus. Okay, now here draw a ray diagram. Now remember the table, or remember the ray diagram which we have drawn. When an object is kept in between f and 2f, images form beyond 2f. So ray diagram, a ray of light parallel to the principal axis after refraction will pass through the focus. Okay. Second, a ray of light passing through optical center will go undiluted. So it will meet somewhere here. It means that is beyond the focus. This is at the end. Fine. So object is here, and this is the image. This is the image A dash, B dash, exactly the corner, and this is the object A and B. Please do not forget to put the arrow. Without arrow, ray diagram will not have a value.